Vietnam is a fascinating country with a vibrant culture and a rich history. Amidst its beauty and charm, there are some unique and quirky aspects that capture the imagination of visitors. From the famous Weasel Poo coffee, known as civet coffee, to the traditional practice of drinking snake blood for vitality, Vietnam offers a taste of the unexpected. Additionally, the country boasts unusual attractions like the Golden Bridge, held by giant hands at Ba Na Hills, and the mysterious floating markets of the Mekong Delta. Whether it's exploring ancient customs or encountering bizarre culinary delights, Vietnam never fails to surprise and intrigue with its weird and wonderful offerings. Don't forget to hit the like button and leave a comment sharing your thoughts on these fascinating aspects of Vietnamese life. Join us on this journey of discovery and exploration. 1. Weasel Poo. Coffee. Vietnam has a special kind of coffee that's quite unique and fancy. It's called Weasel Poo coffee or civet coffee. Here's how it works. There are these small animals called civets in Vietnam, and they eat coffee cherries. Then, they pass out the coffee beans without digesting them. People pick up these beans, clean them really well, and roast them carefully to make a special kind of coffee. Now, what's interesting is that the journey through the civet's belly actually changes the flavor of the beans. It makes the coffee taste smoother, less sour, and gives it a kind of earthy flavor that's different from regular coffee. It's like the civet is nature's own coffee expert, making the coffee taste better in a way that normal brewing methods can't do. This special coffee has become really famous worldwide and is seen as a luxury item. It's called Kopi Luwak and is considered one of the rarest drinks you can find. 2. Drinking snake blood. You know, in Vietnam, eating snakes isn't just a thing for tourists. It's actually a pretty common tradition among locals. While strolling through a peaceful countryside town, you may see some folks handling a snake right there on the street. For them, it's just another day. Now, the way they do it might seem a bit intense. They use a special noose to catch the snake's head and then quickly cut its neck to collect the blood. They pour that blood into a bottle of rice wine, creating what they call snake wine. And get this, they sometimes take it a step further by cutting out the snake's still beating heart to eat as a delicacy. It might sound pretty wild, right? But for them, it's all part of their culture and food traditions that have been around for ages. 3. A city inside a cave. Have you heard about the Sun Dung Cave in Vietnam's Phong Nha Ke Bang National Park? It's this amazing cave that was discovered back in 2009. It's tucked away in Quang Binh Province and is like a hidden gem right in the heart of central Vietnam. Now here's the thing, only about 300 lucky people get to explore it each year, so it's super exclusive and kind of a big deal. But don't worry if you can't snag a spot, because there's another awesome cave nearby called Paradise Cave. It's not as famous as Sun Dung, but it's still pretty incredible. Paradise Cave stretches a whopping 34 kilometers, so there's plenty to explore. 4. Eating and wearing silkworm. You won't believe how important silkworms are in Vietnam. They're like the VIPs of culture and cuisine. First off, they're super crucial for making silk, which is a big deal in the fashion world. When silkworms are in their pupal phase, they spin these delicate cocoons out of fine silk threads. People carefully gather these cocoons to make luxurious silk fabric that's known for being super smooth and shiny. It's what makes those fancy clothes and textiles so special. But wait, there's more. Silkworms aren't just for making clothes. They're also a tasty treat in Vietnamese cuisine. Yep, you heard that right. People actually eat them. They cook them up in all sorts of ways, like deep frying or sauteing them with yummy seasonings. Some folks even toss them into salads for an extra crunch and a unique flavor. 5. Japanese covered bridge. The Japanese covered bridge in Hoi An is a really old bridge that tells a cool story about different cultures mixing together. It was built a long time ago, back in the 18th century, and it's like a beautiful mix of Japanese, Vietnamese, and Chinese styles. The bridge is covered and has these fancy carvings all over it, showing off the different cultures' designs. It's been around for centuries and connects two parts of the town. Not only does it look nice, but it's also really useful because it keeps people dry when it rains. And at the entrance, there are statues of a monk and a dog, which are symbols from the Chinese zodiac, giving the bridge even more meaning. 6. The Hands of God. Up in Ba Na Hills, near Da Nang in Vietnam, there's this amazing golden bridge. It's super tall, standing at 1,414 meters above the sea. The bridge itself stretches for 150 meters and gives you an incredible view of the green hills all around. But here's the really cool part. The bridge looks like it's being held up by giant hands. It's like something out of a fantasy movie. Since it was finished in 2018, the Golden Bridge has become super famous all around the world. Lots of people come to see it because it's so unique and beautiful. Sometimes, though, it can get really crowded with tourists. But if you want a quieter experience, you should try visiting at sunrise. It's a magical time when the peaceful morning scenery makes the bridge look even more amazing. 7. Buffalo Stabbing Festival. In Vietnam's countryside, there are special customs that mix old traditions with local beliefs, making unique festivals. One of these is the Buffalo Stabbing Festival, called Khao Ngu or Khai Quang by locals. It happens every year in coastal villages to mark the start of fishing season and to show respect to the water gods for a good catch. The festival has different ceremonies leading up to the big moment, the buffalo stabbing. People, mostly fishermen and farmers, gather to watch. A buffalo, all dressed up, is brought to a sacred place where a shaman does blessings and prayers. Then, with drumming and chanting, someone gives the buffalo a ceremonial hit on the neck, symbolizing a sacrifice. They believe the buffalo's blood will please the water gods and bring luck for fishing. 8. Floating markets. Imagine floating markets in Vietnam's Mekong Delta, like scenes from a lively movie showcasing the country's food and culture. These markets are special spots where boats filled with colorful fruits, veggies, and spices sail along the waterways. It's a vibrant scene, with smells, sights, and sounds all mixing together, giving you a taste of Vietnamese life. But these markets are more than just places to buy stuff. They're like community centers, where locals meet up, chat, and maybe share a meal. From early morning to late morning, the markets are alive with action as people bargain for goods and swap stories. 9. Women and stewardesses' dress code. In Vietnam, it's common to dress modestly, especially when visiting temples or cities, as a sign of respect for local customs. That means covering up your shoulders, cleavage, and knees when you're out and about. Interestingly, flight attendants in Vietnam face some unique situations. Airlines in the country often have strict rules outlined in their contracts about appearance. This can include things like how long their hair can be, what colors of nail polish they're allowed to wear, and even the types of earrings or accessories permitted. Some airlines might even have rules about how much skin their flight attendants can show while on duty. It's a mix of cultural traditions and corporate expectations, creating a set of guidelines that might seem unusual to outsiders. 10. The Dong Van Plateau. Tucked away in northern Vietnam lies an extraordinary landscape, the UNESCO-recognized Dong Van Karst Plateau Geopark. Spanning over 2,300 square kilometers, this majestic region is defined by sweeping vistas of limestone karst formations. Towering rock pinnacles, dramatic curved ridges, and cave systems dot the terrain, carved over millions of years by natural forces. This geology tells an epic story of Earth's evolution through eons of time. Yet the Dong Van Plateau is not just shaped by rocks, it is the homeland of vibrant cultures. Ancient minority groups like the Hmong, Dao, and Tay peoples have dwelled in this harsh but beautiful land for centuries. Their customs and traditions remain deeply woven into the fabric of daily life. Colorful traditional attire and crafts abound at local markets. Festive celebrations reinforce community bonds and heritage. 11. Vietnamese water puppets. Vietnamese water puppets are a traditional form of entertainment that originated in the villages of the Red River Delta region of northern Vietnam. Dating back to the 11th century, this unique art form involves unique wooden puppets controlled by puppeteers behind a screen, with the puppets performing on the surface of a water stage. The puppeteers manipulate the puppets using long bamboo rods hidden beneath the water. Each puppet represents a character or animal, and the performances typically depict scenes from rural life, folklore, or historical events. 12. Canyoning in Dalat. This exhilarating adventure activity involves navigating through natural canyons and waterfalls in the picturesque landscape of Dalat, a mountainous town in southern Vietnam. Participants wear specialized gear such as helmets, wetsuits, and harnesses as they descend down rugged terrain, rappelling down cliffs, sliding down natural water slides, and jumping into pools of water. Guided by experienced instructors, canyoning tours in Dalat offer various levels of difficulty, suitable for both beginners and experienced adventurers. The routes often take participants through lush forests, rocky gorges, and cascading waterfalls, providing an immersive experience in the beauty of Vietnam's outdoors. 13. Con Dao Islands. Located off the southeastern coast of Vietnam in the South China Sea, the Con Dao Islands are a group of scenic islands. Known for their natural beauty and historical significance, the Con Dao Islands offer visitors a unique blend of stunning beaches, pristine coral reefs, lush forests, and rich cultural heritage. Once used as a notorious prison complex during the French colonial era and later by the South Vietnamese government, the Con Dao Islands now attract tourists seeking a peaceful and idyllic getaway. Visitors can explore historical sites such as the Con Dao prison, where they can learn about the island's dark past and the struggles of Vietnamese revolutionaries. 14. Cu Chi Tunnels. The Kuchi tunnels are an intricate network of underground tunnels located in Kuchi District near Ho Chi Minh City. Built and used by the Viet Cong during the Vietnam War, these tunnels played a significant role in the conflict, serving as a strategic base for guerrilla warfare against American and South Vietnamese forces. Stretching over 250 kilometers in length, the Kuchi tunnels consisted of a complex network of interconnected tunnels, complete with living areas, kitchens, hospitals, storage facilities, and command centers. These tunnels allowed Viet Cong fighters to move undetected beneath the surface, launching surprise attacks on enemy forces and providing shelter from airstrikes and artillery bombardment. 15. Giant's Causeway at Gan Da Dia. Along Vietnam's rugged central coast, an otherworldly sight emerges from the shores of the rippling South China Sea, Gan Da Dia, known as the Giant's Causeway of Vietnam. This geological phenomenon resembles a mosaic art piece crafted by supernatural hands. Thousands of basalt columns form hexagonal patterns along the coastline, believed to be shaped by a maternal dragon spirit, created millions of years ago from volcanic activity and revealed through coastal erosion. Gan Da Dia is now a protected natural scenic monument. Visitors can explore staircases and pathways to witness the diverse textures and stunning views of this unique landscape, where basalt stripes merge with the sea and sky.